Every NHL season has one ultimate goal: to crown a Stanley Cup champion. It's the path to that goal that makes each season unique. Although, to call the 2019-2020 season unique almost feels like an understatement. This was a season of uncertainty, a season of unity. It was a season of resilience. And for the Tampa Bay Lightning, it was a season of redemption.
We're getting you set for Lightning and Blue Jackets Game 1, Round 1 of the Eastern Conference Playoffs. Columbus Blue Jackets come in. The AC Tampa Bay comes in as arguably one of the best teams of all time, at least statistically.
One of the best regular season teams in the history of this wonderful game, the 62-win Tampa Bay Lightning.
The expectations for this team might be higher than any team has experienced in a long, long time.
The Columbus Blue Jackets have advanced in the Stanley Cup playoffs, a four-game sweep.
Never in my wildest dreams did I think that this team could lose four games in a row.
They didn't lose more than
one.
Two in a row all year, and that only happened twice.
I'm flabbergasted.
This is the moment. It's the cold, it's the flames, it's the fog line.
It was a historic regular season followed by a historic postseason. Do you think at any point in the future you will look back on this and be able to reconcile those two differences?
I don't know. I think if we, down the road, win a Stanley Cup, I'll have no problem reconciling that. But right now, it's tough.
Just a big picture look at the Lightning. It's going to happen. Wherever they go this season, they're going to get questions about what happened in the playoffs last season. Is this team mentally prepared for that? Because that's going to be the mental test that they're facing.
I think so. I mean, it's been nonstop all summer for them. You know, every scrum, every interview that we've done, they've continued to be asked.
I feel like you guys will feed off of that disappointment the way it ended last season.
Well, I mean, that's the hope. I mean, obviously no one is satisfied with the way things ended. So, but in saying that, guys are just as excited as ever to get things going.
There aren't many days that you enjoy more than opening night.
The beginning of the NHL season brings new hope. And with that hope, the belief that anything can happen. But while nobody knows what will happen, they know what to expect. An 82-game regular season.
Stamkos fires! Score! He got his 400th goal!
Filled with unforgettable moments in front of millions of devoted fans.
Dave Ayers, what a moment here.
Ovechkin, his spectacular history-making continues. 700 red lights.
It is the 11th straight win for the Lightning, a new franchise record.
All culminating with an electrifying race towards the Stanley Cup playoffs.
It is a great time of year. We've got the playoff pushes in full effect. We've got wild card races that are crazy.
So Boston's 1 point ahead of Tampa Bay for the best record in all of hockey.
However,
the Sharks and Blue Jackets announced that the rest of their games will be closed to the public.
With less than 3 weeks remaining in this season.
Uncharted territory as far as not just sports, but worldwide.
Suddenly, hockey standings don't matter as much.
The National Hockey League made the decision to pause the 2019-2020 regular season.
With the season abruptly on pause due to the coronavirus pandemic, no one knows when or even if play will resume. But with the NHL and its players in isolation, one thing is clear. Everyone is in this together.
This humanizes everything, and it makes everyone realize like we're part of each and every community that we're in.
We're all here to support each other, help each other.
Because right now we are together, and we have to fight through it together.
The better we do this part and stay at home and social distance, then the quicker we'll get through this.
Thank you for your patience. I just want everyone to stay safe, stay home as much as you can, and hopefully we'll see you sooner rather than later.
After months on pause, the NHL announces plans to return to the ice. In an unprecedented effort, the league will construct two isolated bubbles, one in Toronto for the East, the other in Edmonton for the West, providing a safe environment for 24 teams to compete for the Stanley Cup in an expanded playoff format. Each bubble will include a secure arena, practice facilities, hotels, and daily testing for everyone involved.
I give a lot of credit to the league. They did it. It's a good feeling.
Really looking forward to getting back out there on the ice.
Can't wait to get back to playing and hopefully it's soon.
Back in Tampa Bay, enthusiasm builds for hockey's return.
Let's go get some lines up in the middle here. There's a couple guys in the middle.
And with the players back on the ice preparing for action, fans gather to send the Lightning off to the Toronto bubble with some support from home.
We are such a diehard hockey town. And you know, if we can't be there physically with our team, we're gonna be there in spirit.
This is totally unique. I've never done anything like this.
I'm so excited that I feel like I'm going with them.
Never seen this done in sports before.
It takes sacrifice to win the Stanley Cup. And as all teams enter the bubble, it's evident this year's sacrifice is like none before. Ultimate victory means more than 2 months here, away from home, away from friends, family, and fans.
You know, having that signed glass from our fans is gonna mean a lot for us, going down this road.
Regardless if there's fans or not, these guys are fresh and they're ready to go.
It's starting to feel real. It is real.
It is.
It's getting real for us, so it's certainly getting real for the players that are ramping up those workouts and getting everything situated. So before you know it, we'll have the pleasure of watching hockey again.
As Tampa Bay prepares, they are faced with another challenge. Recent surgery will keep Captain Steven Stamkos out of the lineup indefinitely.
He did not expect not to have Steven Stamkos in the lineup. He's a big part of the team. They have a lot of depth. They have skill. They're a very complete team. I think John Cooper's going to continue to mix lines up.
And as everyone settles in and focuses on the task at hand, they realize that the bubble will be the ultimate bonding experience. The result? A league-wide unity that reaches far beyond the ice. With games finally set to resume from inside the bubbles, outside of them, the world continues its fight against the global pandemic. And in the States, the latest incident of racial injustice keeps the country and the world on edge. With all eyes set on opening day of the NHL's return to play, the league and its players continue its role in the struggle for racial injustice and an end to racism.
Racism is a man-made creation, and all it does is deteriorate from our collective prosperity. On behalf of the NHL and the Hockey Diversity Alliance, we vow and promise to stand up for justice and fight for what is right. Hockey is a great game, but it could be a whole lot greater, and it starts with all of us.
The league and its players are unified, and finally, after 4 months of tireless planning, testing, and building, it's time to drop the puck on a historic return.
We waited so long. The pause over, the playoffs begin.
Hockey is back, and in a big way, with up to 3 games a day in each hub city.
Ducey scores!
Recording 2 wins and 1 loss in the qualifying round, the Lightning earned the 2nd seed in the East, setting up a first-round rematch with the 7th-seeded Columbus Blue Jackets.
Together.
Momentum. The Columbus Blue Jackets are coming off a hard-fought 5-game qualifying series win over the Toronto Maple Leafs. They have motivation. The Tampa Bay Lightning have spent more than a year waiting for vengeance after a shocking playoff upset last year at the hands of the Blue Jackets. And the first round of the playoffs is underway. Tampa won the only regular season meeting 2-1 in February.
An early penalty gives Columbus the edge.
Last year, a big part of their sweep, they went 5-for-10 on the power play. It's over to Texier, and he scores!
And after Tampa Bay evens the score, Columbus strikes back in the second to regain the lead.
The Blue Jackets have taken a 2-1 lead.
trailing by one after two periods. The Lightning need some puck luck in the third. And they get it, only 23 seconds in.
Left circle on point. McDonough shoots, save made. Rebound is loose right at the goal line. And Korpisalo, no, it's in! Score! It's Yanni Gord!
Tied after 60 minutes. Tampa Bay and Columbus launch into an epic battle for the game-winning goal.
Game one heading to overtime. Save made by Vasilevsky.
Big save.
This is a test for the Lightning to be able to play a game like this.
I don't think anybody can understand how hard it is on a player to go through that.
Across Hedman, shooting save there by Korpisalo.
But we play on into the fifth overtime period.
By the time we got to the fifth overtime, we said, well, if you pull this one out, I'll give you guys an off day.
Circle Kucherov shoots, block, point high slot. Shoot, score! 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 Braden Point! Braden Point! They went into the fifth overtime! 3-2!
Braden Point literally just whips it, slings it towards the net.
Good afternoon, good evening, good night.
I don't know how many guys on both sides have been in a game that long, but that was something for sure.
From what Tampa went through last year in the four-game sweep at the hand of the Columbus Blue Jackets, this was a huge moment.
Well, Alex, after nearly eight periods of hockey on Tuesday, how did you guys go about resetting and recouping over the last 36 hours or so?
Mentally, you just gotta try to get away from it for a day. Tough game for both teams. I think just, you know, making sure we were getting our bodies recovered, getting liquid in us, just doing everything we can so that we're ready for today.
Well, after playing the equivalent of 2.5 games, we're dropping the puck here for game number two.
Showing no signs of fatigue, Nikita Kucherov gives the Lightning an early advantage. Already down 1-0 in the series, the Blue Jackets had their backs against the wall, and they respond with three unanswered goals.
Bjorkstrand fired it home right off the pass. He had plenty of room, and he's given Columbus a 2-1 lead.
Wedberg
gets in front, takes a shot, and he scores! Alexander Wedberg does the heavy lifting, gets to the front of the net, and gives the Blue Jackets a 3-1 lead.
That will do it. Blue Jackets come back after the marathon game one, and they show exactly what they're made of. They got the lead, and they just shut it down over the final two periods.
Despite Tampa Bay being tied at one against the team that vanquished them a year ago, the Lightning are seemingly relaxed and confident heading into game three. With an opportunity to take the series lead, Tampa Bay hit the ice with a renewed sense of energy.
All right, man, let's have some fun. Cirelli up ahead for Killorn, 2-on-1. Killorn works in, scores! And the Lightning grab the lead.
You gotta cash in when you get the opportunities. And this one here, he certainly fooled Korpisalo.
Columbus, just like in game two, evens the score. But this time, the Lightning respond differently, led by two of their stars, Braden Point and Victor Hedman.
Shooting an arm save, Nate. Rebound! Score! Braden Point!
For Verhaeghe across the line right circle. High slot Hedman.
Score! Victor Hedman! A huge goal! It's 3-1 Lightning!
After the Blue Jackets cut the lead to one early in the third, Tampa Bay takes control and never gives it back.
The Lightning win game 3-2, and they lead the series 2-1.
Can the Blue Jackets bounce back again? They've yet to lose two in a row in the playoffs. They've yet to win two in a row either.
Game 4 is pivotal for both teams. Tampa Bay can seize command of the series, or Columbus can tie it. It appears the Blue Jackets strike first.
And score the rebound.
Tampa's challenging the entry here, so we'll see if the play was offside.
After review, the play was offside, therefore there's no goal. Please reset the clock to 18:49.
So, 18:49 to go here in the first period, still scoreless.
Taking advantage of the Blue Jackets' mistake, the Lightning rely on their scoring depth and ensure Columbus does not take the lead again.
Fast start here for the Lightning in the second. Down away. Goodrow drops it back.
Chattinger lines and fires, scores, tipped in front, and the Lightning have a 2-0 lead.
Well, this line is at it again.
And although Andre Vasilevsky allows one goal,
gets attempted by Vasilevsky, the Blue Jackets are on the board.
He doesn't give up another.
The Lightning win it 2-1, and they lead the series 3-1.
Well, I'm sure I'm not the first to say it. Fourth one's the hardest one to win. You know when your season's in the balance, how they're going to come out. You just have to match the desperation of the other team. Boom!
More than 400 days after their devastating loss to the Blue Jackets, Tampa Bay is just one win away from advancing. But Columbus won't go easy. Surviving Columbus's early first period attack, the Lightning quickly gain momentum and the lead.
Shoot! Score!
The Lightning go up 1-0.
Here's Coleman shoot! Scores! Blake Coleman steps in and fires it home, and the Lightning now have a quick 2-0 lead.
With their season on the line, Columbus fights back.
And behind to Wendberg. Looking for Foligno on the doorstep. They score! And the Blue Jackets capitalize, and they cut that lead to 2-1.
Corpusalo, rebound Bogosian.
Oh, my God.
In front, off the block. Foligno back the other way, maybe a 2-on-1. Across the blue line, left circle in front for Nash. Poked away by Vasilevsky. Wow. Penalty coming up.
A costly penalty by Tampa Bay gives the Blue Jackets more life.
To Atkinson, to Seth Jones, feeds it across. Stedlin to drive. Vasilevsky save. Rebound. Stedlin scores! Kevin Stedlin, power play goal. Ties the game at 2.
Now tied, Columbus isn't finished yet.
Another chance for Wendberg, shoots, scores! Alexander Wendberg, with 15.8 seconds left in the period, has given Columbus a 3-2 lead.
Adding a fourth unanswered goal, the Blue Jackets' desperation seems to be paying off. But the Lightning are determined to end the series. And even though just 8 minutes remain in the third period, for Tampa Bay, that's still plenty of time.
Kevin Shattenkirk,
a bomb from the top of the right circle, and it's 4-3.
Sergachev across the Hedman, walks in, plays it back across. Kucherov shoots, Corpusalo makes the save, point feeds it, and they score! Puck home by Anthony Cirelli, and the Tampa Bay Lightning have tied the game with 1:38 to go.
This is going to overtime for the second time in the series.
It's as simple as that.
Out of the reach of Gavrikov in front, points him up, he scores! Braden Point has won the series for the Lightning! 5-4 in overtime! John Cooper in Tampa Bay moving on in the Stanley Cup playoffs.
Braden Point scores 4 goals in the 5 games, and the Tampa Bay Lightning avenged last year's first round playoff loss.
At the beginning of the series, 422 days. I mean, who's counting, right? I was counting. That could be boys. It was a tough 422 days.
4 weeks after entering the bubble, 8 teams remain. And from here on out, it only gets harder.
It's a marquee matchup, and it's only round 2. Tampa against Boston.
In round 2, the Tampa Bay Lightning face the Boston Bruins. Led by their perennial stars, Boston came within 1 game of winning last season's Stanley Cup and then followed it up this year with a President's Trophy for the most points during the regular season. And since becoming Boston's starting goaltender during the first round of these playoffs, Yaroslav Halak has been unbeatable.
This series has a little bit of everything, right? You got the skill, you got the toughness, you got the physicality, and 2 of the better teams in the entire National Hockey League. What more can you ask for?
Marchand of the near point, Carlo brings it. They score!
Yeah!
Charlie Coyle got a deflection, and the Bruins with a 1-0 lead late in the first period.
You gotta tick those fellas. We gotta tick in the line.
Sent across, Pastrnak fires, they score! David Pastrnak, 2-0 Bruins.
McDonough had it taken away, Finrod, score! On a feed across from Pastrnak to Marchand, and it's 3-0.
On this night, the Bruins overpower the Lightning right from the start. Tampa Bay pushes back.
Score! Victor Hedman has gotten his team on the board!
Shoot.
Score!
With 1:14 left, the Lightning made it 3-2. Hedman has 2 goals in the game.
But ultimately, it's not enough.
And the horn sounds, and the Bruins win the first game by a score of 3-2.
The forwards need to do a better job tonight for Tampa.
They're making it far too easy for the Boston penalty killer.
First night of a back-to-back, they can't go down 2-0.
Trailing in a series for the first time in these playoffs, the Lightning face what feels like a must-win in Game 2. Just as in Game 1, Boston scores first.
Crosby, what a ripper by Bjork, wouldn't go scramble in front. They poke at it there, and it's a goal!
Make him pay, boys!
But tonight, the Lightning counter, led by a key trade deadline acquisition, Blake Coleman.
Score! Blake Coleman! But what a rush by Zach Bogosian!
Both teams continue to exchange goals.
Looks across, fires deflected, they score! Directed in by Marchand, a power play goal! Bruins 2, Lightning 1.
Shattenkirk.
Score! Big goal!
And finally, the Lightning take their first lead of the series.
Breakaway pass to center. Here's Coleman from Hedman. Score!
But it doesn't last long. Boston ties the game late, forcing overtime.
Marchand scores!
Wow, what a response by Boston.
The stakes are high in overtime. The Lightning are one shot away from trailing by 2 games, or one shot away from changing the dynamic of the entire series.
Wide right, you got Maroon by that. A wraparound try, loose in front, Pallon!
Score! Pallon! The Lightning win it! 4-3! And this series is tied up 1-1!
Teams that can go down like this, and there's teams that go like this. You give up a goal with 4 to go, what happens? This happens. All right, you just got to believe it was an exercise in persistence. That's what it was, persistency. That's how you did it.
The next day, inside the bubble, Boston and Tampa Bay gear up for a pivotal Game 3. Outside the bubble, reports surface about an NBA player protest of another police shooting of a black man in the United States. Just before game time, a decision is made to move forward with play.
Racism has been embedded in our society for far too long. Today and every day, the NHL and the hockey community are committed in the mission to combat racial injustice and achieve a fair society for all. The NHL would like to take this moment to call out to our fans and communities to stand up for social justice and the effort to end racism.
22 hours after Andre Palat scored an OT to win Game 2 for Tampa, it's a new dimension in this series between the Bruins and the Lightning as they play back-to-back.
Energized from their Game 2 overtime win, Tampa Bay sets their sights on a series lead.
Palat scores! A one-timer from Andre Palat. Here's Yanni Gourde in a low and turn, shoot, scores! And Yanni Gourde scores 15 seconds after Palat's goal.
Deliberates, got it back for Sergachev, he scores!
Now this has turned into a runaway for the Lightning.
After 2 tight games, the Lightning offense breaks through in Game 3, chasing Yaroslav Halak and handing Boston a demoralizing loss.
It was one of those nights for the Bruins. Didn't handle the adversity very well. They paid the price for it.
You're not going to see many games like that. Bottom line is, you gave nothing in the end. I mean, it's just one game. But it's a statement game to me, man. That's a statement game.
The morning after Tampa Bay's decisive Game 3 win, the NHL, led by players in both the East and West bubbles, makes a statement on social justice and decides to postpone 2 days of games.
Official word from the National Hockey League.
After much discussion, NHL players believe that the best course of action would be to take a step back and not play tonight's and tomorrow's games.
I think if you look around this room, there's a lot of white athletes in here, and I think that's the statement that's being made right now. I woke up to, you know, a text from Kevin Shattenkirk, and he had a bunch of guys out east there, and they wanted to talk, and then I got a text saying Vancouver wanted to talk, and you know, that I think was more powerful, that it started, the conversation started with white players on other teams.
When we realized that they were, Vancouver and Vegas, I think were considering sitting out tonight, and got to speak with them and speak with Ryan Reeves and talk about obviously the issue at hand and how important this is. I think it was something that we were all fully behind, and obviously with what transpired yesterday and the other leagues sitting out, you know, I think we felt that we took our time and were able to process this as a whole and speak as a group of players and make the right decision.
The conversation and the statement that's been made is very powerful, especially coming from this league.
After an emotional two-day pause, Tampa Bay's focus now shifts to Game 4.
Yaroslav Halak was pulled in the second period of Game 3. He's looking to bounce back. It's all or nothing with Yaroslav Halak in goal for the Boston Bruins.
Andre Palat tallies 2 goals.
Center and blocked by Krug. Point again.
Put it in front. Palat! Oh. Score! Palat!
The bouncer is settled down there by Cirelli. Give it one back for Halak. Score! It's Palat!
And Victor Hedman adds a third.
Center point Hedman. Shoot!
Score! That hit something and pinballed in!
Tampa Bay's 3 goals are enough to push the Bruins to the brink of elimination.
Vasilevsky was terrific, so was his team, as they have defeated the Boston Bruins 3-1, and they lead in the series 3-1.
If Tampa Bay wins Game 5, it will be the final game for both teams in the Toronto bubble. The Lightning will move on to the conference finals in Edmonton, and Boston will head home.
If you're Tampa, don't change a thing. Don't let the Bruins off the hook. You've outworked them in the tough areas. You want to continue to do that. Don't show any cracks in the armor.
No turnovers for 60 minutes. We're just rolling and rolling and rolling. All right, fellas, here's a chance to close them out here, boys. Welcome back, Mac.
Let's go.
The Lightning are up 3-1. Can put it away.
Game 5 is a battle right from the start. While the Lightning strike first,
fires a shot, scores, and the Lightning have taken the lead 1-0.
Stay high, Pally! Woo!
Both teams exchange a series of goals.
Shot pass on, a shot, score by Pasternak! And the game is tied!
Keep going, Blue, keep going now!
Score!
Yeah! Let's go! Let it go, boys, let it go!
With the Lightning ahead by 1 goal and less than 3 minutes remaining, the Bruins make a final push.
Do not force plays. We can use our timeout if we're not ready.
On a cross now, and Chara shot. Yeah. Rebound, yeah. Score! Krejci! And the game is tied!
Game 5, an elimination night for the Boston Bruins. And the Tampa Bay Lightning is going to overtime.
In the first overtime, the Bruins outshoot the Lightning 11-7. While Boston's desperation shows on the ice, it does not show on the scoreboard. But in the second overtime, Tampa Bay controls play and finally gets an opportunity.
Hedman walks in, shoots, yeah! Scores! Woo! And the Lightning are on to the Eastern Conference Final.
That was a gutty effort. I mean, everybody threw that together, but I mean, there were tongues were dragging, and it was just a battle of wills. Who had enough left in the tank to do it? And I guess we did.
While the Lightning await their yet-to-be-determined Eastern Conference final opponent, they enjoy a much-needed day off, one step closer to their ultimate goal. The Lightning have a brief moment of team bonding and relaxation before departing for Edmonton.
I'll be honest, I didn't see this happening on day 35 of the bubble. Although in Tampa, you'd think we'd do this.
I am confused because I'm seeing the other side of the bubble. So I'm like, wow, this is amazing. But I'm also confused that, like, I haven't seen one fish. And I don't even know if I'm doing this right, to be honest with you. I think I already broke the rod.
Whoever wins this year, I'll tip my cap to them. I mean, I damn sure hope it's us. But I think part of our success is the guys have been really focused on what's at the end of this and probably why we're having the success we're having.
The success feels good. A day in the fresh air, perhaps even better. But Tampa Bay is only halfway to claiming Lord Stanley. They exit the Toronto bubble and head west, searching for 8 more wins. 42 days after 2 hockey bubbles open, the NHL consolidates into 1. The final 4 teams will battle for the Stanley Cup in Edmonton. The Dallas Stars face the Vegas Golden Knights for the Western Conference Championship, and the New York Islanders, 2 days removed from their Game 7 win over the Philadelphia Flyers, square off with the rested Tampa Bay Lightning for the Eastern Conference crown.
They have played, all right? They've gone through an emotional series. They had to travel yesterday. We came here a day early. Take advantage of it. It starts in Game 1, and you just wear them down.
Dan O'Rourke drops the puck. Sit back and enjoy Game 1 of the Eastern Conference Final.
Through the first 2 rounds of the playoffs, the Lightning have been led offensively by Braden Point and Victor Hedman.
Point, diving in front, shoots, score! What a goal by Braden Point!
And early on in this series, it is no different.
There's Hedman with a shot, he scores!
Leading 2-1, halfway through the first, Tampa Bay asserts its dominance.
Ryan McDonagh hammers one home. Tampa Bay with a 3-1 lead.
In Game 1, everything seems to go right for the Tampa Bay Lightning.
Out in front, it's Maroon. He'll settle it down. Play it off the goaltender.
How you going?
That puck go in?
Yeah, I think it may have, yep.
Are you kidding me?
And wrong for the New York Islanders.
To Beauvillier, he shoots. He scores. Well, they're waving that off.
How did that not go in? Did he save that?
Andre Palat with another brilliant finish for the Tampa Bay Lightning.
And the Lightning win it by a final of 8-2, a huge offensive night.
It's funny how different games are when you go on a playoff run, boys. Bottom line is, eventually you gotta get 4, and you can't get 4 without getting 1. All right, so you got it, but expect a whole different game the next one.
It was a hot start for Tampa Bay in Game 1, but on the morning of Game 2, they aren't taking anything for granted.
I think it was great for us to come off of a weeks-long rest and be able to jump right back to our game and make sure that we didn't really miss a beat. We have enough guys in that locker room who have some playoff experience to know that tonight's going to be a much more, you know, intense battle out there.
Welcome tonight in Edmonton, Alberta, game number 2. It's the New York Islanders and the Tampa Bay Lightning.
The house, baby.
The first few minutes of Game 2 should tell us a lot about whether the Islanders can make a point.
Skates it down behind the Tampa net, in front for Matt Martin, shoots and scores! And he gives the Islanders the early 1-0 lead, less than 2 minutes in!
Leading for the first time in the series, the Islanders press harder, and the physical play intensifies. Proving costly to the Lightning.
Brock Nelson back out to center.
That's a bad hit by Killorn behind the play. Easily see a 5-minute penalty here to Killorn.
Regardless what this is, fellas, we gotta kill this off. Take him out.
Gotcha.
He's done?
Killorn, that's all for him. Major power play circumstance for the Islanders.
The Islanders can break this game open. And the timeline's down to the major. The Lightning are back to 5-on-5. No power play goals allowed.
Following a critical penalty kill, Tampa Bay answers back.
Hedman off the draw. They score!
And that is a huge goal for the Lightning to tie the game at 1.
Victor! Attaboy.
But is dealt another blow to its roster.
He falls awkwardly into those boards there.
Still tied at 1, Late into the third, it seems that game two will be settled in overtime. But with a depleted bench, extra time is the last thing the Lightning want.
32 seconds left in this third period. And now in front of turnaround shot. Varlamov got a piece of that one. Palat had him dead to rights. McDonough across. They score! Nikita Kucherov awaiting on the weak side. 7.8 seconds left. Tampa Bay with a 2-1 lead. The Tampa Bay Lightning lead the best of seven series. 2-0.
Going into tonight, if you told me we're going to lose two guys in the first 5-10 minutes of the game, kill a five on three, can't make that up, man. The poise and composure you showed in between periods on the bench, it paid off, fellas.
Living in the bubble and playing hockey nearly every other day, any opportunity to get outside is a welcome one. So a day after their Game 2 victory, the Lightning enjoy an afternoon at Commonwealth Stadium.
Today is about getting outside a little bit. Get a mindset of hockey for a day and then make sure we recharge.
This is the first time I think majority of us have probably been outside since we got to Edmonton besides, you know, maybe the courtyard for 5-10 minutes here and there.
It's everyone on the team gets along with each other, so I think it's great, and it goes a long way when you're battling out there on the ice, when you have a group of guys that you can trust and know that are going to stick up for you whenever you need them.
Game number 3, Eastern Conference Final, the Tampa Bay Lightning and the New York Islanders. Tampa Bay tonight without the injured Braden Point, without the suspended Alex Killorn.
With Tampa Bay missing two of its stars and the Islanders desperate for their first win of the series, the scale tips early in New York's favor.
Quick shot, caught him up, he scores!
And through the first two periods, everything is going the Islanders' way.
Here's Pelech, shoots, he scores!
Oh, what a play! Nelly sends a bow! It's 3-1 Isles!
We learned a lesson in the second period. What was the lesson? You deviate from the plan, and it won't work. So you learn from these. Just learn from it.
Sergachev walks in over to Kucherov, slides it in, they score! Kucherov elected not to shoot this time. He slid the puck to the front of the net, and it's a one-goal game.
Moved at the point, they score! Tipped in!
Tampa Bay ties the game in the third. But ultimately, New York's desperation prevails.
Are up 4-3 in game 3.
The Islanders seal their win.
He hits the bullseye and he goes right after Nikita Kucherov.
And the dislike between both teams is evident.
Let him go.
We got ourselves a series.
Playoff hockey.
Heads, go have a shower, okay, bud? Cal, go have a shower. Heads, shower.
Final count, the Islanders 5, the Lightning 3.
Rivalries are made in the playoffs. Are you starting to see a little bit more dislike between the two teams now as you get series gets longer?
I don't know if it's a rivalry, but they don't like us, we don't like them.
The Eastern Conference Final has reached game 4 in a best of 7. The words may not be new, but they were fresh after the last game. From one team to the other, we don't like them and they don't like us.
Me? Yeah, you. What am I going to do?
Yeah, exactly.
I'll do whatever. I fight whoever I want. Yeah. Are you playing tonight?
I am.
You are? All right, we're going to play hard. Here we go. Let's roll, boys.
The bad blood from game 3 carries right into game 4.
Hey!
A hard game today, isn't it, eh?
Oh, that was a UFC takedown.
And once again, New York grabs the lead.
Oh, Nelly Brock picks the upper right corner, and the Islanders have the 1-0 lead.
But energized by the return of Braden Point and Alex Killorn, Tampa Bay ensures this game will have a different result.
Here's a breakaway, Coleman and alone. Score! Blake Coleman!
What a huge response by the Lightning.
Way to weather it, boys. Way to weather it.
Point slipping one through, and a chance to score! And it's 2 to
remarkable set of circumstances.
Hey, Pointer, be ready here.
Centers it, Pointer shot. Score! Braden Point! Huge goal!
Yeah!
3-1 Lightning!
The Lightning not only take control of Game 4.
Down ice, Pat Maroon skating after it, looking at that open net. Score!
They take control of the series.
And the Lightning defeat the Islanders to take a 3-1 stranglehold on this Eastern Conference Final.
You know what's going to happen in games when you're in the Conference Finals? The other team's going to make a push. It's the way it is. And you weathered it. Not only did you weather it, you went down and you took the lead. That's a championship team.
It's day 52 of this most unusual playoff, and for the Islanders, we've reached the, if necessary, part of the Eastern Conference Final. They have to win, or the rest of the games won't be necessary.
For the Tampa Bay Lightning, it's like, look, we win one game, we're going to the Stanley Cup Final, and pretty much enough said.
And game five is underway. Gord wins the faceoff.
Gate! Take the shot!
Big drive! Score! The Islanders strike first!
It's battle time right now, fellas. Want it!
You've seen the puck, boy.
Shoots, the kicks they've made. A rebound loose. Hedman shoots! Score!
Yeah! Game is tied!
Both teams play with urgency. And still tied late in the third, New York makes a potentially costly mistake.
He's tripped and a penalty coming up now. Maybe a high stick.
Where'd you get it, bud? Where'd you get it?
With 1:23 left in the third period.
Unable to capitalize in regulation, Tampa Bay carries the man advantage into overtime. Now, only one goal away from the Stanley Cup Final.
Across to Kucherov, right circle shot. Kick save made by Varlamov.
That was a good save. That was a great shot and a good save.
Tighten up in the neutral zone. Play connected, fellas.
High slot shot. Save Varlamov. He'll cover. We'll just about do it in the power play, so the Islanders are going to escape this.
Second overtime. 81st minute coming up. Nudged ahead for Cirelli. Cirelli dropped it back and a shot by Pelletier. Oh, and a rebound, and it did not go.
Off the side of the net there for Kucherov after the initial shot happened.
It looked as though it might be a great opportunity for this game to be ended by the Lightning and the series to be as well.
Shattenkirk at the right point tees it up. Whiffs and a shot. Now Martin punches it out to center ice. Maybe a 2-on-1.
Lee to the left circle. He's with Everly down the middle. Feeds him. Shoots. He scores!
Yeah!
Yeah! Jordan Everly has won it in double overtime!
Yeah!
The Lightning have lost in overtime for the first time this playoff year. That means we are going to have a game six on Thursday.
So now they got another game to go. They got to win the next game or else you're putting it down to one game. So the pressure's on.
While there might be concern outside of the bubble following Tampa Bay's heartbreaking Game 5 loss, inside the bubble, the Lightning, led by head coach John Cooper, remain unfazed.
You start reading what the people are writing about you, you'll be sitting with them soon. So I don't read it, and I don't watch it. It's the next game that's always the toughest. We know what to expect. We know how we have to come out. Now it's just time to do it.
Game six of the Eastern Conference Final.
Let's do it. Let's do it.
One game away from moving on. One game away from going home.
Every shift, every shift.
Passes in, a bouncing puck, a wraparound score! And for the fifth consecutive game, the Islanders have opened the scoring.
Every game this series, no matter which team scored first, the other scored second. And Victor Hedman makes sure this pattern continues in Game 6.
Hedman again! Oh, that was a great shift by the Lightning, and Hedman has tied the game at 1.
24-6 are the shots now in favor of the Lightning. They're piling them up here on the power play in the second period.
You guys are doing awesome things.
And that's it. Two periods played.
Okay. You know, you're getting some looks. We're getting a few shots, that whole thing. If you feel frustration, don't. Okay, it's a wasted energy. The bottom line is, the reason you were getting all those chances is because you were doing the right thing. So don't change what you're doing. All right, you don't have to. All right, because if you feel like, oh, I got to do something different, then something different happens. All right, and it's usually not the right thing. We don't need to change the game plan. We just need more of the game plan. All right, fellas? 20 minutes here, fellas. Dig as deep as you can and stay together. All right, boys, let's go.
The two teams once again remain deadlocked deep into the third period.
Last minute of the third period, once again tied 1-1.
As in Game 5, the Lightning receive a 4-minute man advantage in regulation.
This is so reminiscent of Game 5. The Islanders take a penalty that will carry over to overtime.
Here's a short-handed breakaway. Brock Nelson alone. Steven Vasilevskiy.
Unbelievable, boy.
The similarities continue as the Lightning are unable to convert on the power play.
Do you believe in omens? If so, which way does the omen shift?
Boys, we got to end those plays. When we get the chance to end them, we got to end them. Cirelli.
Overtime in the playoffs creates opportunities for anyone to become a hero. And for Anthony Cirelli, currently without any points in the series, one shot does just that, bringing the series to a sudden, albeit confusing end.
Goodrow around behind. Oh, and Cirelli scores! Yes. Or does he?
Is it in?
Yeah!
Score! The Lightning win! It's over!
What a
goal! Stanley Cup final! Here come the Lightning!
Hey, if we couldn't get there, I'm sure glad you guys got there.
Okay,
hey, win it now. Man. You deserve it. They're one of the best, man. Go win it. Go win it.
All three of you guys go get it.
That's it.
We're right. You win a trophy, we pick it up. There's a few guys in this room that were here in 2015. You never forget the ups and downs of going to a Stanley Cup final. I know there's guys that haven't been there to embrace this moment. You know, as coaches, we give you a little direction. We just stand there and cheer. You guys are the ones that have to do it. You know what? Somebody should come smell me. You hug 20 sweaty hockey players the way I have. The exuberance and relief, it's unparalleled. We've been in a hotel for 54 straight days. It might be one of the hardest cups ever to win.
It started with 24 teams. It is now down to two. Tampa Bay is four wins away from hoisting their second Stanley Cup in franchise history. Only the Dallas Stars stand in their way. Led by their captain, Jamie Benn, all-star Tyler Seguin, and an unlikely hero in goaltender, Anton Khudobin, the Stars eliminated the Calgary Flames in round one. Clinch round two with a dramatic Game 7 overtime win against the Colorado Avalanche. And after disposing of the Vegas Golden Knights in a five-game series, the Dallas Stars are Western Conference champions for the first time in 20 years. Former Tampa Bay assistant coach and current Stars head coach, Rick Bowness, is facing his former team in the final. The morning after Tampa Bay's Game 6 win, both teams prepare for the NHL's annual media day, which, as with most other things this season, has a different look.
Can you describe to me what today is like, media day without media?
You're kind of looking at it, it's different.
What would winning the Stanley Cup mean to you right now?
I mean, obviously, the world.
You're grinding it out defensively and winning some low-scoring games, and I just wonder about the overall confidence level of the group.
We keep doing what we do to what makes us successful, and it's been working out so far.
Here we are, after 124 games in two bubbles, about to watch the Stanley Cup Final like no other.
Boys. The game hasn't changed. We're still playing it on ice in the same board, same size rink, same everything.
A grand old trophy will be awarded here.
Who gets it? The Stars or the Lightning?
There's no more opponents. This is the last one. This is the only group that's holding us back from our goal. Don't let them take it from us. Take it from them. Let's go.
Often as a player, when you get this far, you sit in the dressing room before you go out and you hear the sound, the music, and you hear the fans. This time you don't.
On 4 days rest, the Dallas Stars have the luxury of going with the same lineup that closed out the Golden Knights. Never mind 4 days, the Tampa Bay Lightning have had 45 hours to get ready for game one.
I think the Stars have an advantage.
That blue team will find out quick. They're gonna hit them hard. Right, Jay, Yanni, let's go, let's have a good one here.
Right up!
Oh, who we got? Right on, boys.
Watch your center, watch your center.
Help up!
Door, right up!
Our twitch is slow right now, boys. We're playing this game too slow.
The Lightning have lived in the bubble for 55 days now. And although it's been a grind, they have largely dominated on the ice. Tonight is different. The Dallas Stars are bringing the fight to them.
Braden Point went down hard. A steal, roping hits by the net.
Hits good for somebody in front. And Henley scores!
For Tampa, they have not faced a team that is as quick as Dallas in these playoffs.
There we go.
Hey, Eddie, watch him pushing it forward.
Early on, Dallas is clearly the better team. But Tampa Bay catches a break and escapes the first period with a score tied.
Sid squibs in! It's in the net!
The lucky bounce and goal fail to change the dynamics of the game, and the Stars keep the Lightning off balance in period two.
Took the puck, pass back to Oleksiak, he moves in and shoots. Big save, rebound, score!
We're out of our structure. Get back to it.
Keep it going, Matt, keep it going!
Veranda with a shot, rebound, score!
I thought you were like falling back, so I was gonna go.
Well, I was, but then I didn't see you going on.
In the third period, Tampa Bay finally mounts a sustained attack.
Let's get better. Everybody's got to be moving.
But Stars goaltender Anton Hudobin stops all 22 of their shots.
Save made Hudobin, but he holds on.
Worked back by Johnson. Drive by McDonough. Save. Rebound cleared.
The Dallas Stars will win the first game of the Stanley Cup Final 4-1 over the Tampa Bay Lightning.
It's only one game, but tonight, Tampa Bay has no answer for Dallas's speed and tenacity.
That's a great skating team. They make it tough on you, and they're going to continue to make it tough on us, so we've got to be ready for the challenge.
With Tampa Bay now trailing in the Stanley Cup Final, one game to none, questions about the return of their captain, Steven Stamkos, take on a new urgency.
If he does come back, do you think he'll have an impact when he hasn't played a game since February?
He's a superstar. To some extent, it doesn't matter how much time off he's had. I think if you see Stammer, you're going to see the best of him. And honestly, an 80% Stammer is better than most players in this league.
Any chance that Mr. Stamkos could play next game?
He's been skating on and off today. He's out there with the guys, but
as of now, I don't think so. So I gotta tune in to find out.
Game number two. How physical that first game was, over 100 hits.
We need to be on them, we need to be forechecking. Don't cheat the game, don't cheat yourself. Play the game right, play it hard, and good things will happen. Let's go.
The Steve Stamkos watch is now in high gear, but Stamkos did not take the warm-up, so he will not play tonight.
Here we go, fellas. Come on, boys. Let's go, boys. Let's go here.
Guys, count. I like it. Here
we go. Keep grinding here, boys. Keep grinding. Keep this going.
Tipped back along by Chernak. And one of the Lightning went down.
That was Kucherov.
With Stamkos still out of the lineup for Tampa Bay, Dallas tries to capitalize. But a lack of discipline proves costly.
A penalty is coming up.
Gotta talk about hard plays, boys. We gotta be hard.
The head and left point. Right circle Kucherov. In front point. Score!
Point! Beautiful!
What a pass by Nikita Kucherov.
I like my team. Play, boys. I like coach.
Come on, boys. Just keep rolling. Keep rolling.
Stick on stick. Watch his back.
Another penalty coming up.
Another one, Doc, against Dallas.
Double drop.
Hedman. A lot.
Hedman fakes the shot. Kucherov, a hard pass. Palat shoots. Scores.
Tells you a lot about the mental strength of Kucherov.
Well, they got some confidence now.
The Lightning score three unanswered goals in the first period.
For the shot, he scores.
And a crowd gathers.
Oh, you're in their head, boys.
In the second period, it's now Tampa Bay who lacks discipline.
Right here, 37's going for the cross check.
But the Lightning defense steps up.
Here we go, fellas. Come on, boys. Come on, boys.
You're an animal, Chernak. You're an animal.
As does goaltender Andrei Vasilevskiy.
Shoot, Damon. He shoots against the ceiling by Vasilevskiy.
Who stopped 17 of 18 shots in the period.
Vasilevsky's been able to shut the door.
And ultimately leads Tampa Bay to victory.
And back on the shot dumped by Klingberg. Didn't get much on it. And the series is even.
Gutty one, boys. Gutty one. You win them in different ways. It's an unreal job by the PK there in the second period. Phenomenal, boys. This one here could go, obviously, to a ton of guys, but I'm going to point one out. He got hit pretty good and gutted one out in the PK. Journey.
Two more, boys, so keep it going.
Yep. Yeah.
In this year's unique postseason, a long playoff run is a double-edged sword.
Wow. This is quite a setup.
While the Lightning are only 3 wins away from Stanley Cup victory, it's been nearly 2 months since they've seen their families. For one Lightning player, that's about to change. John and Janice Goodrow, parents of winger Barkley Goodrow, have just cleared their final hurdle to enter the bubble.
We were so thrilled when they opened up the bubble to include parents and siblings, because originally it was just wives and girlfriends and significant others. Barks messaged me, he said, Mom, are you sure you want to do this? Here's the list of the things you have to do. Are you sure? I said, hello, this is your mother. Of course. We haven't seen him since March 12th.
After having watched the first 2 games in our hotel room, we're really excited to be able to see tonight. It's to see him play in the final. It's special.
As the Goodrows look forward to reuniting with their son, news of another sort of reunion is breaking in Edmonton.
Great excitement here in the bubble and great news for the Tampa Bay Lightning.
It's official. Lightning captain Steven Stamkos re-enters the lineup tonight.
Tie series, 91 in for the white shirts.
Welcome back, Stamkos.
Yeah.
Hey-o.
Okay, remember, if we don't have to set, don't set. But you gotta make sure we're skating with lanes and we're going. All right, fellas? Let's go here, boys. Come on.
210 days since he last played a game. The Lightning captain is back.
It just gives you an emotional boost.
Come on, boys. Come on, boys. Let's go here, 91.
Here we go, guys.
Heads up.
Heads up, heads up.
Go, go, you go, you go.
Okay.
Close it, close it.
Keep buzzing, boys.
Yeah.
Oh, come on.
Oh! Stamkos out on the ice.
He's got the muscle memory, knows exactly what he has to do, and his teammates are very happy to have him.
Whoa!
Even!
Skate, skate!
Oh, and a giveaway here!
Shoot, angle! Finish! Finish!
Kucherov's in alone, and he scores!
What a shot!
Yeah! Woo! There we go, boys!
Good start here, boys, good start!
By merely stepping onto the ice, Stamkos inspires his team. On his third shift, he alters the momentum of the entire series on a play that is sure to go down as Stanley Cup legend.
Gotta keep going north here, fellas. Push that puck north.
Sent back ahead and escaping back up the wing of Stamkos. He scores!
Yes!
My goodness, right out of a storybook, and it's 2-0.
Wow, what a shot.
No rust in that department.
That is unbelievable.
Although Stamkos does not return to the ice after the first period, the Lightning continue to play motivated hockey.
Keep pressing. Don't exhale here, boys.
Scoring 3 more goals. And maintaining their grip over an increasingly testy opponent.
Total number of hits tonight, 102. 103 and 4.
you doing, man?
He's cross-checking me. I'm not gonna let him cross-check me. I guarantee you're not gonna score with me out here, though, so.
And more confidence gained tonight by the Tampa Bay Lightning as they have defeated the Dallas Stars 5-2, inspired by the return of their captain, have taken a lead in the series 2-1.
There's mountains still to climb, all right? But you know we've got the formula. So let's just cut to the chase right here. This could go to none other, the guy that just missed out on getting the GW, Steven Stamkos. Yeah!
To see the transformation that we've had from where we were last year to now is unbelievable. And we're 2 games away. And it's gonna be 2 of the hardest wins we're ever gonna have, but this is the group, and I got a great feeling.
Following the emotional Game 3 victory, Barclay Goodrow heads for an emotional family reunion.
Hello.
So glad to see you. Oh, I miss you.
Good, how are you?
Great, good to see you. Great game.
Thank you. Yeah.
That's not yet.
That's two.
Yeah, that's two. Halfway there.
Tampa Bay is now only 2 wins away from claiming the Stanley Cup, but the most grueling stretch lies ahead, and the Lightning will have to get through it without their captain. Steven Stamkos is ruled unfit to play and will not return for the remainder of the final. For just the second time since 1955, 2 final games, games 4 and 5, will be held on back-to-back nights. As it turns out, the next 28 hours will prove to be even more difficult than the Lightning could have imagined.
Game 4. Will it be 3-1 or tied?
Okay, man, have a good game tonight.
This is a must-win game here in Game 4 for the Dallas Stars.
This Tampa team, they've got the Stanley Cup in their sights.
Footstep. Go, go. Shoot it.
Klingberg's back in for Dallas. His shot blocked. Another chance. Score!
Nice, boys. Hey!
That's a lucky one, boys. That's a lucky one.
In the first period, Dallas manages just 3 shots on
Here's
goal.
Jimmy Benn has a cutter.
But they make them count.
Fed to Pavelski. He shoots. He scores!
Woo! Boys, come on. That doesn't hurt us. Bring some energy here.
With 33 seconds left before intermission, Tampa Bay finally breaks through.
Braden Point scores! What a beautiful goal! And what an answer for Tampa.
Let's go now! Pick your heads up! Come on!
And that's it. Pretty good first period.
Knowing the series could hinge on this game, both teams play with purpose in the second period.
Rod, we need you guys going here. On the puck, on the puck.
High slot and shoot. Save Udobin.
Hey, we keep this up. Simple and hard. Simple and hard.
Killorn. Got the puck to Point. He scores.
It's 2-2.
In the third period, now tied, Tampa Bay takes its first lead of the game.
Killorn able to peel away from behind. Fires one. He scores. 4-3, Tampa Bay.
But it doesn't last long.
Sagan fires a shot from the sharp angle. Pavelski turns to his forehand. He can score! It's a 4-4 tie. And this is the first game of the Stanley Cup Final that is going to sudden death overtime.
Boys, these are the moments, eh? Big goals, eh? Who's going to step up?
Okay, you've shown sick resiliency. Just tilted the ice, tilted the ice, tilted the ice. Do not pass up shots, all right? Don't. Come at them in waves.
Period number 4.
Get up, get up! Hard run!
Oh, and a great save made by Udobin!
Hey, he's tired, let's go. Get there!
Jay, let's go. No, it's not. Let's go, it doesn't matter!
5 minutes into overtime, Dallas captain Jamie Benn takes a penalty, giving Tampa Bay a man advantage and a pivotal opportunity.
Come on, boys, they're 1 shot away, let's go.
Here's Hedman, then across now for Shattenkirk.
Shattenkirk moves in, takes the shot, he scores! Kevin Shattenkirk has given the Tampa Bay Lightning a 5-4 victory in overtime and they're one win away from the Stanley Cup.
What a moment for Kevin Shattenkirk, where he was getting bought up by the Rangers last summer to score the game-winning goal in overtime. What a moment for him.
I can't even remember how really how long I've been in this room or in Edmonton. Hopefully this is the last clear app that we're doing.
Veteran Kevin Shattenkirk joined Tampa Bay on a one-year contract after a frustrating stint with the New York Rangers. This season, Shattenkirk has become an important part of the Lightning, both on and off the ice.
Every morning I come on game days, grab a coffee for me and a coffee for Victor. We started doing it in Toronto. Can I grab a large dark roast, one milk, one sugar, and another dark roast, just black, please? It's worked. So I think there were two or three times where I messed up and forgot, and we lost those games. So now it's a must that I come out here and grab him a coffee.
There you go.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
There you go. He's extremely superstitious, so I don't know how crazy he's going to be this morning.
Victor Hedman's rituals seem to be working. With 10 goals so far in the playoffs, third all-time for a defenseman, he's a major reason why Tampa Bay is one win away from hoisting the Stanley Cup.
Stammer not being in the lineup, I miss a lot of firepower and it got to come from somewhere else. And I'm taking that upon me to be more of a threat shooting. Winning the Stanley Cup, it would mean the world to me. It would be my biggest dream come true as a hockey player. And, I think it's the same for the rest of the guys.
Rogers Place, Edmonton. Stanley Cup inside.
One team has a chance to win the Cup. The other team's in survival mode.
Tampa Bay alternate captain Victor Hedman says, I'd like the Stanley Cup. Dallas says, not so fast. Lightning can clinch. Dallas can extend.
Guys, let's have a good one. Both guys down. There we go.
Good action here at either end.
Buddy!
More hitting taking place. That has been the hallmark of this series.
Come on, boys. Too long a shift. Too long a shift.
Hit it out!
Go!
Helps him, keeps it in. Sagan is there. Perry scores!
Yeah! Send it up one person. That was it.
Keep working him. All right, move pucks.
In the attacking zone, Palat on his backhand. Cuts in front. He scores!
Like Game 4, Game 5 is a back-and-forth contest. And for the second night in a row, Tampa Bay delivers what appears to be a knockout blow.
Point. Led on back. Sergachev a shot. He scores! And it's 2-1!
Only for Dallas to deliver a counterpunch that keeps the game, and for now, the series, alive.
There's 7 minutes to go in the third period. Sagan to Hiskanen, his shot, they score! A rebound to Joel Pavelski, and it's a tie game.
Is there enough drama for you? Both teams have lost only once in these sudden death periods this summer.
Keep that strong side shot mentality. Make sure we're skating.
All Tampa Bay right now.
It's Kucherov. Moves in, shoots, and that's deflected.
Good roll. Ricocheted off the ball and hanging on to it is Hudobin. My goodness.
Keep shooting the puck, boys. Keep shooting.
In double overtime, the Lightning continue their onslaught.
Oh, what a rising shot. A great opportunity there.
Under pressure, the Stars weather the storm and finally get their chance to attack.
Klingberg takes the shot. Hit a body. Corey Perry trying to stuff the puck in. He scores.
The Dallas Stars have forced a game six.
An incredible hockey game.
Sportsnet. Your hair's on point.
Oh, thanks. I was going to say you too. With the bandana's a nice touch. Well, Pat, last year with the Blues, you had a chance to win it at home. It doesn't happen then, but you get the job done in Game 7. What do you remember about how you handled the days in between those games that could perhaps...
A Stanley Cup champion in 2019. Pat Maroon was signed by Tampa Bay to provide toughness and leadership in situations like the one they face today, Game 6, and their second chance to finish off the Dallas Stars.
We can't really focus on what's at stake here. We got to focus on, you know, just playing another hockey game and find ways to, you know, get to our game early.
Your history with John Cooper goes back to the days in the North American Hockey League between Texarkana and St. Louis, who won a championship together in 2007. How has he changed over the years?
He knows how to handle players. He knows how to manage the bench. He knows when guys are going, so that's always a good sign. He has a feel for the game. He's made a few appearances in the Cup, so hopefully, you know, we can get this one for him.
Floors block shots tonight, eh? We got to get in lanes, including myself.
Couple things. If there's one thing we learn about the playoffs, primarily goals are scored from the inside. You have to get there. This is the part that means the most. Run our breakouts. Play the game fast. If we have to step on a guy, do it. All right, let's go.
There is a boatload of energy in this building. And I know it's probably hard to believe with no fans, but you can feel the excitement.
I think the pressure squarely lies on Tampa Bay to wrap this up here tonight.
All right, man, let's have a great game 6. When you're ready, Yanni.
2 months into the playoffs, almost a year since the puck dropped in the start of the season, game 6 is underway.
If the team in the white wins, they get the Stanley Cup. Banked back down, and no icing on this play. But now we get a stoppage of play and a penalty call.
I got you for the trip.
What a chance.
Kucherov's over here on this side of the ice.
Spins and deals. Britton Point moves in and shoots it over. Rebound score! Britton Point and Tampa Bay has a 1-0 lead.
Send more shot points!
As he's done again and again this postseason, Braden Point delivers a timely goal. This one makes him the playoffs' top goal scorer with 14. When Tampa Bay takes a penalty just minutes later,
number 77, 2 minutes for interference.
Another Lightning superstar rises to the occasion, just as he's done again and again this year.
Haskinen moves in and shoots! Second a drive and a save made by Vasilevsky.
Some quality chances, but Tampa Bay netminder has the answer.
Andrei Vasilevsky has played every minute in goal for Tampa and should be in the Conn Smythe Trophy conversation.
And that does it for the first period.
All right, fellas, a couple things. One, the period didn't get going for us because we were getting a little too cute. When it did, you got pucks behind their D. That's the whole key. They struggle to get out against us. Okay, so just keep getting it behind their D.
With a lead and two periods of hockey left to play, the Lightning sense the Cup is within reach and up the intensity.
Hey, the D are pinching every time, so maybe that we can bypass them. Good battle in front. Watch that stick in there.
Keep going here, boys. Yeah, keep going.
Let's go, cut.
One more! Maroon cuts off the pass and counters across the blue line. Let's go to Paquette. Right to go, Coleman!
Score! 2-0 Lightning! And what a play in the neutral zone by Pat Maroon!
Radulov looking for Klingberg, and look at that, that hand-eye coordination.
Going here, boys, keep going.
Let's go!
Oh, keep attacking! Hey, we have nothing to protect! Keep attacking!
Coleman with a rocket of a shot that is held by Hudobin, and there's more between Gord and Ben.
Hey, you need 2 goals, not 2 minutes, okay?
You invested in the process. For 2 periods, you've invested in the process. Invest in the process one more time.
After 65 days in the bubble and 531 days since their stunning exit from last year's playoffs, the Lightning are only 20 minutes from lifting their second Stanley Cup in franchise history.
Hey, watch your sticks now, watch your sticks!
But the Dallas Stars won't go quietly.
Hit me. You're fine, Eric, get it on the space!
No time to flex your muscles right now, boys, no time to do that.
I know that, and you don't like it!
The first bit of a surge in this game coming for the Stars.
Chivirenta moves back in, changes position, gets a great shot. There's a rebound. Vasilevsky with 2 big saves. And there'll be a penalty on the play.
Don't line up here. Come on. You got to get ready when we pull them, right? About a 2.5 minute mark.
Can they cut the lead in half on the power play? Trigger pull there and a great save.
The clock ticks down under 2 minutes.
I'm pulling the goalie.
Now!
He's off.
So now the extra attacker.
Last minute of game number 6.
You gotta get a block! Block!
Bennett shot, and that one blocked as 3 of the Lightning players went sprawling.
15 seconds left. Radulov by the net. Right point, Klingberg shoots. Block! It's out of the zone! Into the net goal zone!
The bubble has burst.
The Tampa Bay Lightning have won the Stanley Cup!
Did it, boys!
Number 91, fully dressed, has joined the celebration. For Tampa Bay, this has been an awfully long time in the making.
Tampa Bay Lightning were on a mission, no doubt about it.
Hey, golf player. Good job, man.
Thank you, Bonzi.
You did a great job, brother.
Thank you.
You're a hell of a player, a hell of a person.
Thank you, Bonzi. I appreciate it, buddy. Thank you so much.
The Conn Smythe Trophy is awarded to the MVP of the playoffs. With 10 goals, third all-time on a playoff run for a defenseman, Victor Hedman.
I'm actually going to get to pick that up. I can't believe I'm actually going to get to pick that up.
The greatest trophy in all of sports, the most historic, the most coveted. It is my honor to present the Stanley Cup to Steven Stamkos.
In a season like no other, after a playoffs the likes of which the sport has never seen, the Tampa Bay Lightning stand alone atop the summit of professional hockey. There are no fans to cheer them, and for most of the Lightning, no family to share in their accomplishment. But for a moment, all of this is forgotten as they take Lord Stanley's cup in hand and celebrate as countless other champions have before them, knowing that they've etched their place in hockey history.
I don't know if I have words to say how proud I am of everybody here and the heartbreak it took us to get to this point. But we got one puck left, and it goes to none other than our goaltender.
Feel. Unreal. Can't wait to get back to Tampa.
And I'm here with first-timer Kevin Shattenkirk. Tell me how it feels to actually touch the mug.
Last night, drinking out of this bad boy with you guys was you're one of the sweetest drinks I've ever had. Yeah. Good boy. Down the hatch. Take it while it's hot.
It's a hell of a feeling, that's for sure. I might be able to set my almost one-year-old in it. I think my boy is too big. Mila is pretty tall, but
Mila's the best.
She called me this morning and said I heard you won the big trophy, so she's excited to see it. So I'm pumped to see him.
It's
It's been a wild ride. But these boys were on a mission. And after everything that happened last year, for these guys to pick themselves off the mat and go win the Stanley Cup, we can't thank you enough for your undying support. Let's say we do it all in the river tomorrow and have a little bit of fun.
The real fans that have been with us since day one, this is for you guys.
The 2019-2020 season was unprecedented. The path to the Stanley Cup, remarkable. But after it all, the Tampa Bay Lightning return home Stanley Cup champions. Back to their families and back to their fans. Back to the city that supported them on the long road to redemption and hockey immortality.